Joining me now is Republican Senator Tom Cotton of Arkansas. Senator Cotton, thanks so much for being here, as always.
Good afternoon, Jake. Good to be on.
So take a listen to House Speaker Paul Ryan earlier today.
We, as Republicans, who fought the creation of this law and accurately predicted that it would not work, ran for office in 2010, in 2012, in 2014, and in 2016 on a promise that we would, if given the ability, we would repeal and replace this law. This is the closest we will ever get to repealing and replacing Obamacare. The time is here, the time is now. This is the moment, and this is the closest this will ever happen.
Senator, your response? He's saying, this is it.
Of course, that's not the case, Jake. There's no urgency here. There's no deadline. We need to get health care reform right. We don't have to get it fast. What we need to deliver on is the promise that we would make health care more affordable for Americans, we would make it accessible, and we would cut down on the stress and the anxiety that health care causes for Americans. Unfortunately, the House legislation is not going to achieve those results, and the breakneck speed at which it's moving is designed to actually make those results probably worse. That's why I think we just need to take a pause and to deliberate more carefully and more openly and get to a result that's actually going to make healthcare more affordable and more hassle-free for Americans.
Steve Scalise, the House Majority Whip, yesterday told his Republican members, many of whom are skeptics like yourself, you're either with Pelosi or with Trump on this. So are you with Pelosi?
I'm with the American people and the promises I made to Arkansans that we're gonna reduce the cost of their health care and make it accessible and give them more control over their health care choices. Look, there are a lot of Republicans who are saying these exact same things in private. Frankly, some of them on Steve Scalise's whip team are saying the same thing. I'm simply saying in public what many Republicans are voicing, that the legislation as it's written, one, probably cannot pass the Senate, but two, would not solve the problems of our health care system, problems that Obamacare made worse. I think the American people care much more that we solve those problems than that we meet some kind of arbitrary legislative deadline.
What would you tell a voter who wonders about your party's ability to govern? I mean, repealing and replacing has been the GOP priority for years and years. You won the House in 2010, the Senate in 2014, the White House in November. I mean, how is it that your party's leadership doesn't have a plan that can pass the House and Senate?
Well, that voter would probably look at what's happened this week and have questions about the governing process. Introducing legislation on Monday night to vote on it Wednesday morning without any kind of cost estimate and continuing those votes through the dead of night is exactly what happened during Obamacare. We need to take a pause. We need to have hearings. We need to develop fact-based body of knowledge in which we can address the very thorny questions that healthcare raises. And so we can synthesize the many plans we have, because that's ultimately the issue, Jake. Not that Republicans don't have a plan, but we have many plans. And we need to coalesce around one of those plans, against the various parts of those many plans into a single plan that can get a majority vote in the House and the Senate, and that will once and for all solve the problems of our healthcare system. I simply do not think the process that we're undertaking is going to achieve those results, nor do I think the House bill as written will achieve those results.
And one of your big substantive issues with the bill as it's written right now is that it does not do enough, in your view, to control spiraling health care costs. Studies I've seen suggest that the biggest driver of health care inflation right now is pricing increases, particularly of drugs, of medical devices, and of hospital care. What should be done to discourage corporations from jacking up their fees for drugs, devices, and hospital care?
Well, Jake, there's a couple of different issues there. Drug prices, for instance, you mentioned. There are things that can be done outside the context of repealing Obamacare to address, for instance, drug companies' abilities to increase the cost massively for old generic drugs. But putting that aside, Obamacare has contributed to those increases in health insurance rates, in part because of all the regulations it imposed. Well, this bill does very little to address those regulations. This bill creates a tax credit to help lower-income Americans pay for their health insurance, yet it pays that tax credit to insurance companies, not to taxpayers. This bill does not address the one most important idea on which Donald Trump campaigned, which is to eliminate the antitrust exemption that healthcare companies have and operate on a state-by-state basis and rather have a nationwide market. On the Medicaid front, there are some changes that could be made to give states even more discretion and flexibility than the draft proposes, but we should also hold more accountability for those governors and legislatures if we're going to give them that discretion. Those are just a few of the examples of what I think that we could do if we slowed down, took a pause, and considered this matter more carefully.
Senator Tom Cotton from the great state of Arkansas, thanks so much for your time, sir.
Thanks, Jake.